Do you ever look at your own life and say, and you're a surprising naturalist, you're a surprising, for the lack of a better word, animal person, because, you know, I mean, you literally went from Sorbonne to Yale to Paris Review, and I mean, what was it that drove you to go to Africa and to go in search of something?
Well, I think it began at my mother's bird feeder, probably, and my dad is a hunter, and I used to hunt too, and somehow I got interested in animal behavior. My brother did too. My brother's a marine biologist, and I specialized in ornithology, and he went to marine biology. So it really started very early, since we were about 8 or 10 years old. You know,
There must have been some wanderlust there, though, wasn't there?
Well, that kind of began because when I first started writing novels, they weren't selling very well. And I went to the New Yorker magazine. Mr. Sean was still there then.
Yeah.
And said, will you send me around the world? I really just wanted to see wilderness and wildlife, but I needed it as a way of life too, as an income. Yeah. So everything kind of came together that way. It was something I loved to do and was getting paid to do.
Do you prefer nonfiction to fiction?
No, I prefer fiction.
That's what I thought, mm-hmm. Yeah.